How many keepy uppies can you do?
Yeah, good question. I've never asked that.
Thank you. Give me a ballpark of how many balls you can
rough
pop.
Estimate.
What? Till I get bored.
No, oh, so what do you mean? You can do more than five?
Guinness World Book of Records. Is that what it is? No,
I'm not saying that, but I mean...
Give me a number.
Like, I don't know, like 500 something.
No, you can't.
No, you
that
can't.
That is utter bullshit.
Your foot would fall off. I'm Harriet Rose and this is Under the Duvet. Welcome back. This is our final episode. Boo. But I'm very excited with our guest today. But before that, if you're listening to the podcast, we are live at 5 p.m. and the YouTube video will be going out on Thursday at midday. Now, I'm very excited because, of course, we had to have our All-Stars winners, Tom and Molly. Look at you two. Before the cameras were rolling, they were being very cute with each other. I'm not going to lie. I'm seeing real love and affection here, guys. And you were just mentioning about meeting the parents.
Yeah.
It's happened. So both parents or...
Yep. Was it? No. Well, actually...
Oh, hi.
Hello.
Oh, sorry, I know you're
recording.
Sorry, I'm straight in.
You're fine. Are you joining us?
Hello.
Sam Thompson's just walked in to come and join us.
Oh, thank you, bro. Thank you, mate.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you, mate.
Oh,
thank you.
Bye, Sam.
See you later, bro.
A little visit from Sam Thompson to tell you how much he loves you. That's lovely.
Yeah.
Anyway, back to the parents. So, what did we think, guys?
Well, Tom met pretty much my whole family.
Oh.
Yeah. Brothers, nieces, nephew, mum, dad.
The dog, everyone,
Nelly.
Oh, so you have met Nelly. What was Nelly's thoughts?
Nelly really likes Tom.
Yeah. Oh!
She was giving him kisses straight away and then sat on his knee, so...
Yeah, bless her.
I honestly have been waiting with bated breath to find out what the dog thinks because I've got a cat and
my cat...
Yeah.
Me too.
Yeah. You were panicking, right? Because that could have been the end of it all.
It could have been.
Yeah.
No, it actually could have been.
Imagine you're just going to split the money and see you later because Nelly's not a fan.
If Nelly didn't like him, see ya. Yeah.
That is the most important thing, though, I think, with a relationship is making sure your family and your dog likes your boyfriend.
I think dogs have good senses, too.
They do. They know.
Yeah.
Well, congratulations on winning All Stars. How does it feel?
Bizarre.
Yeah, I've said to everyone, like, it doesn't feel like we've even been on it. It doesn't feel real. No.
It's a blur. Yeah.
It's because you found love. Oh, I'm so jealous. Anyway, we're going to talk more about life, but first we're going to talk about the final. What an exciting night.
I know.
Were you sat there being like, yeah, we got it in the bag?
No,
yeah.
Absolutely not.
Really?
I was shaking.
I had clammy hands.
He had clammy hands.
Sweaty feet.
Clammy hands.
I never get clammy hands. I'm like, Mom, my hands are clammy, man.
Also, how do you know your feet are sweaty?
Well, because I had shoes on and my toes kept slipping forward. Yeah. And I was saying to Tom, I was like, oh my God, my toes are literally going to be gripping the top of my shoes. So I had to keep like pushing them back.
When we had Chris and Joanna on the show last week, they were saying how nerve-wracking it was to be live on telly. Is it because you've been on telly for such a long time, for weeks and weeks and weeks, but this is like live, go for gold, like you've got to smash it on the first time. Do you think that is what it was?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's mad. I think even like Josh, we were laughing at Josh because Josh seems to get nervous on the recoupling speeches.
Yeah, he does.
And then Josh got up with Maya and I can't remember, what did he say now? I can't remember, but he was stuttering and we were just pissing ourselves.
Yeah, because he was the first person to say, I'm really, really, really nervous.
Yes. Yeah.
Like, and
it's the atmosphere as well.
Yeah.
And then there's like an audience there and everyone keeps looking.
All the lights and
you stood there and yeah.
And all of a sudden they're in your house.
Yeah.
It's like suddenly letting like 50 random strangers, including Stormzy, come and sit in your front garden. Did you meet him?
Huge. Yeah, he's massive.
You're huge.
Yeah, but
is he bigger than you?
I don't know.
He's taller than you.
Yeah, I think he might.
Couple of big lads just hanging out.
Just chilling.
Must have been huge for you, Molly. Even huger.
I know.
That's exciting, though.
Yeah, he was lovely. He was really nice. Proper nice.
Oh, that's nice to hear. Yeah. So while you're sitting there and your feet are slipping out your shoes because you're so sweaty, you'd obviously had a few of the public votes in the villa.
Yeah.
And it had gone your way quite a few times. So surely that made you feel a little bit more confident.
Yeah, but no. Because you got voted most intelligent, and I'm sorry.
I think that was just that my mum voting. Yeah. Time. Thanks, mum.
Your mum and then, go. Everybody, go. My son, he's clever. Wait, so does that mean you're stupid in real life?
No.
Molly?
What's she doing?
No, I just
Just not the most intelligent.
Neither of us are. We're all right.
No, same as me. Back I'm not. Ourselves. Guys,
yeah, actually, yeah.
It's kind of cool not to be clever. Right? I'm not very clever.
I think they were more intelligent people in the villa. Yeah, let's put
Who
it that way.
Who was the most intelligent person in the villa?
Well, didn't Jess have like 11 A stars or something?
Yeah, she does. But then I remember telling Jess, like, I used to tell her I'm from Cambridge. And I was like, I'm from up north. I was like, oh, what school did you go to? She said, tell me a school. I was like, oh, no way, I went to that school. Like, going along with it. And I used to say, like, random footballers' names who I said went to that school, like David James, Peter Schmeichel. And she's like, I know them. They went to my school and stuff like that. I was like, what?
Do we think that's just because she's so nice that she doesn't want to let you down? She's like, Peter Schmeichel went to my school.
She's thinking, what's this weird on about?
She's like, I really want to get out of this conversation. I agree with everything you're saying.
Yeah, probably.
Oh, sweet Jess.
I know.
Well, obviously, you were in the final with Jess and Callum.
Yeah.
They were second place. Is that what you expected? As in for Callum and Jess to be second?
I thought they might have won it, you know, in between them and Josh and Soph.
What made you think that they might win?
I don't know. I just think they were like the strongest couples in there from what I'm seeing anyway.
Because obviously you see something so different to what we see. Because for me, I guess Jess and Callum had been together for such a short amount of time that I was not shocked because I think that like they seem great, but I was shocked just from the fact that they'd been together for such a short time.
Yeah.
Where do you think a lot of the public love for that couple came from?
I think obviously Callum had a bit of a journey in there, and I think he handled himself very well. So probably from that sense, I think Jess is a lovely girl as well. So
yeah.
I think the public liked them both together and stuff.
I mean, there was only 2% of the vote between the two of you as well.
I know, yeah.
It's kind of cute, really. It's kind of cute that it was so close because it's usually like, to be honest, it just shows the sort of love for you all in the villa.
Yeah.
And obviously, Molly, we have to get into you having to honestly be with your ex-boyfriend for, I don't know how you did it, honey.
I know.
Because you'd catch me flying straight out that villa.
I know.
I'd have walked in like you did, seen the back of his head and gone, well, I'm out of here. But, you know, having come out of the whole experience, how are you feeling now having done that and kind of doing something that no one in real life actually ever has to do?
No, good. I feel good. I mean, obviously, I've come out with Tom, which is amazing.
Yep.
So got what I needed when I went in there.
Absolutely.
But, yeah, I think it was at first, I won't lie, it was a bit of a struggle because it's just an awkward situation to be in. But when Tom came in, I was fine then. I was like actually really enjoying the experience. So,
and I really rated, I've got to say, I really rated how adultly, what's that word? Maturely.
Adultly.
Most intelligent.
What did I tell you? how maturely you dealt with a lot of the situations, because I personally think with exes in any scenario where you have to, because obviously you had a similar situation, Tom, in there, not as long standing with Georgia, but you know, you still had to be in there with someone you dated before. You're always going to feel something for that person. Sometimes it might be hate, sometimes it might be love, sometimes it's something in between. And to acknowledge, this is a person that I dated for 3 years, but you're the person I'm focusing on. You're the person I want to be with.
Yeah.
It's kind of like, I really liked your honesty there. Because I think you said something to Tom in the villa where you asked, you know, is there anything still there? And you were like, this is a person I've dated for 3 years. I'm always going to kind of not have feelings, but I'm kind of going to have a link.
There's a level of respect there for someone when you've like with them. Yeah, of course.
Thank God you didn't hate him completely and utterly, because that would have been a nightmare.
I know. Could you imagine that?
I can. And it's in my nightmares. were you genuinely surprised to see him?
Yeah.
The back of his head.
So before obviously I came in, I was sat in a trailer like waiting to go in.
Yeah.
And they kept delaying me going in and delaying me. And I was thinking, oh, please, I just want to go in now.
Yeah.
And then they came in with a piece of paper of everyone who was already in there, like the starting lineup, because obviously I didn't know. And I had an inkling that maybe he could either already be in there or he'll be coming in because it's all stars.
Yeah.
And like we're exes and stuff. I knew that you were going to have a possibility of being in there, obviously, that you know. And he weren't on there. And I thought, oh, yes, I've got my moment.
Yeah.
And then when I walked in and saw the back of his head, I thought, brilliant. Great. Stole that, didn't he?
But also, it does go to prove that you can recognise someone from the back of their head.
Yeah.
Because I don't know it, but you can, can't you? It's like a feeling. It's like a vibe that you feel from a mile away. Because lots of those boys have got the same backs of heads. Not going to lie. You have
same trim.
Yeah, the same trim.
You know what? It'd be interesting if we actually just got pictures of all the back of their heads and seen if we could say who was who.
Exactly.
I'd do quite well at that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think you would.
Do you know what? Molly's really talented. She might not be the cleverest girl in the villa.
But you can tell someone from the back of his head.
I can see you from the back of your head. And obviously there was a vibe with the discourse, and I don't want to go into this loads because I know it's frustrating for you guys to talk about, but I feel like everyone listening at home is going to be annoyed if I don't ask. How did you genuinely feel in the villa when people were saying things about you and Callum getting back together? Was it just a frustration or?
Yeah, because I don't understand where it came from. Mm. Like when after we had them video calls from home, there was quite a few people who had said it on them. And being in there, you'll even say this, like there is just no vibe. Me and Callum hardly really spoke.
Yeah.
It wasn't a situation where it was like we'd have little chats and like go off together and talk. We just had a friendship and a level of respect. And then for some reason, this narrative was running that we were meant to get back together.
Do you have TikTok, both of you?
Yeah.
You know how when you scroll on the algorithm and it's like a tarot reader and she's like, oh my God, your ex is coming back.
Oh yeah.
Right? I wonder whether the general public, because I've definitely done it before, I'm not going to lie, where I'm like, oh my God, they're coming back. They're coming back. I feel like we might have an obsession with getting back with your ex, like in general life. I feel like that might be that weird thing that a lot of people, so it might have just been conjecture from.
I think as well, it's seeing two people live together 24/7. Like you don't do that.
Mm.
So like, I think from an outside point of view, you're watching two exes live together. It's, you kind of, I don't know, create your own story, don't you?
It is berserk. Every time you say it, I'm like, that is not, you couldn't catch me dead doing that. Tom, obviously there was a bit of a wobble from you from that. I think you did so well dealing with that situation because it's no one's fault.
Yeah.
There is no one doing anything to perpetrate the situation, but you dealt with it because I think it's natural to have feelings, but you did have a bit of a wobble, as you should.
Yeah.
But, you know, how did you deal with that when you were in the villa? How did you feel kind of coming away from that?
Obviously, I remember, I think it was Arabella told me first. I was like, like one video call, but like, all right, that's a bit weird. But then it was free.
Mm.
So yeah, at first, like, I think with me, obviously, as I've got older, I've learned to deal with situations better. And normally when I was younger, I'd probably let my emotions get the better of me and get a bit heated. But I just took a breath and I was like, I actually trust Molly. And I feel like if there was anything she would have told me, she's given me no reason not to trust her when we was in the villa. So we spoke and stuff, and obviously other people are having chats about it, but I'm like, look, I trust Molly. She said there's nothing. I haven't seen anything.
That's the other thing. It's a shock, wasn't it? Because no one had seen anything.
Yeah, that
was none of us understood it. From all of us living together, it was like really out of the blue.
Yeah.
I do just wonder whether it's that thing of like people, it's like the rom-com. It's the rom-com storyline that people wanted to see take place. You know, like, oh my God, I've always loved you. And it's like, actually, you can have love for that person and then move on with somebody new who's more.
I don't even think it's like a love, though. It's more just like a level of respect.
Yeah.
It's just more like we respected one another and like we had each other's best interests at heart. So.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And going forward, I mean, Tom, you and Callum seem to have become best mates.
Oh,
so
get on like a house on fire.
Which is so lovely and kind of doubles down on the idea that.
Yeah.
There isn't that vibe there.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Aren't you going to go on dog walks together or something? Is that going to happen? Has it happened yet?
It was briefly mentioned.
Yeah, it was briefly mentioned. But look, no, I do get on with Carl. Obviously, it is always going to be a bit weird than being Moll's ex. And stuff, but I do get on with him. I remember in the Believing on the down days, like we'd just chat as lads and just go on about football or whatever. So no, I think he's a good lad and he was very good to me. Obviously with Molly, he could have easily been a dickhead, but he wasn't. I do get on with him, but there is always going to be that little, not weirdness with it being Moll's ex, but no, I really get on with him. I think he's a good lad.
And now that Nelly likes you, you don't need help with the dog walks, do you? Because you're like, I don't need you anymore because she likes me. Done.
Yeah, I was nervous. Exactly. I was nervous to meet Nelly, I'm not going to lie. I was a little bit nervous. Yeah.
When you came out of the villa, obviously it's that very intense moment. You're in the final. What's the actual thoughts that's going through your head as they're about to announce the names? I'm just desperate to know because I would be like, probably.
That was the most nerve-wracking thing.
It was.
When the music's going like,
yeah, because it's really like, and it's deadly silent as well.
Yeah.
yeah, no one's making a noise. No. Just stood there waiting.
All the lights were on you. It was like, yeah. What is this?
So your feet are sweating, your hands are sweating. Yeah. And now your face is...
Out.
Yeah. You're sliding.
Me toes are gripping my shoes. Absolutely tragedy.
Yeah, but also I feel you because I think people don't realise, live TV is scary as it is, but when you're about to find out if you're a winner of a show that's the first time it's ever happened.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah. It's pretty stressful. What are you going to do with the cash? Most important thing, because I think, Tom, you said before you went in that you'd go in for a price of a Prada bag. Now you could buy like 10 Prada bags,
babe. For what?
Price of a Prada bag, is that what you said?
No, I never said that.
Apparently you did. That's what I heard.
Is that
Chris? What you said?
No, I never said that.
Okay, but are you going to buy a Prada bag?
Is that what you said?
No.
That's what you said.
Guys, is that what he said?
Well, he can buy me a Prada bag. Oh, there's witnesses!
Oh, was it?
Nah, he definitely meant it.
Did
fully
I
meant it.
I can't
definitely
remember.
Meant no, it. No. Is that why you've been saying you want to buy a Prada bag?
Whenever I said to you, I want a Prada bag.
No. So what are you going to buy then?
Prada bag?
I'll get more Prada bag. I haven't thought about it, to be fair.
I haven't thought about it, to be honest.
Yeah. You're going to spend 25 grand on Nelly, aren't you? Just to prove...
Dog toys. Yeah. Everything.
She's going to be living in a
gold.
She'll
be in a Prada bag.
Yeah.
I'll get Nelly a Prada bag.
Right, let's talk about your journey. Molly, you went through a lot of ups and downs.
Yeah.
I feel like people love a journey in there.
I didn't.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's not so nice for you.
Yeah.
How did it... let's get into a little bit the conflict with George S. From time to time, you know, you guys clashed a little bit.
Yeah.
How did you find that being in there? Clashing with another girl, because it's always like, you know, girl code, you don't want to have too many.
Yeah, of course, and it makes it awkward for the other girls as well. But I think at the start, me and G got on really, really well.
Yeah.
So we were fine, and I think we're quite similar in certain ways as well. But it was just when it all started, obviously you've had a bit of history, G, and then she was chatting to Carl at one point and stuff, so it all just got a little bit awkward.
Mm-hmm.
But we never actually fell out. Like, we're absolutely fine now. We just had a few little moments where we grated on each other a little bit.
And I think if that doesn't happen, something's going on. Because, like, there's no way... You're being real in the villa. And it's like, we have conflict. We have... Yeah, even with our best mates that we see every single day, you know, you want to tell them to fuck off every now and again. Yeah. But, like, it in that sense, you kind of saw that because you... I think there was a point when you... had a conflict, and then literally the next day you were like, squashed, let's move on.
Yeah, we were really good at that, actually. We used to just kind of like put everything to bed. You have to live with people 24/7.
Yeah.
Like, it's not time to carry on.
You haven't got time for it.
No. Well, you actually do, but...
Yeah. Too much time. She's having a bit of a tough time on social media.
Yeah.
I think it's really hard to see that when coming out of the villa, especially because we don't see the whole thing, really, do we? But it's good to hear that you guys are like...
Oh, yeah, no, we're absolutely fine.
Which is lush.
Yeah, that was all kind of put to bed a while before, actually, at the end. I think, like, the whole last week was really nice. We all were getting on really well. And
it seems like everyone's got what they wanted, you know? Everyone's come out with someone that they seem super happy with.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And it seems like a kind of zen ending.
Yeah, because normally there's, like, friendship couples sometimes, isn't there?
Yeah. There was none at the end. Yeah,
that last week, everyone was really, like, lovey-dovey, weren't they? All in their own little couples and... Yeah.
Tom, you seem like a super chilled person, like, almost constantly horizontal.
So chilled.
Yeah. Did you get into, like... Because, like, obviously there was moments of... Oh. Go on.
Actually.
What?
Does he get the zoomies? Is that what you're going to tell us?
Go on, what are you going to say?
She's working out if she wants to say it or not.
Go on, say it with your chest.
Oh, I feel like, no, you are very chilled.
Yeah.
But you do have your moments where, like, you and Casey would be, like, on one a little bit. And then you sometimes a little sulker.
Oh, a little grumpy bumpy.
I think for me, like...
Not in a bad way.
No, but it's just normal, guys. You're allowed to be human.
Yeah.
He just sometimes gets a bit...
Tired and emotional.
You are quite emotional.
My social battery dies.
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah.
Babe, I feel you.
Yeah. And I feel like I don't like drama. I never have. I feel like years ago, I used to be maybe quite hot-headed in some senses. But now, like, if there's drama and it's nothing to do with me, I stay clear of it.
Yeah.
I've got no time for that.
You chill.
Yeah, I'm so chill.
Yeah. I think it's normal and also very progressive of you to not, you know, but the one thing that you did do, which deeply confused me, was when you let your flatmate crack on with your lady.
Should we talk about
about yeah,
that?
Yeah, I think we should.
Yeah, I do.
Because honestly, that was the weirdest thing I've ever seen in my life. Like, talk us through why you said to Casey it was...
Best friend.
Best friend. Who you live with. Who you live with.
Try it.
Imagine if you'd swapped. Then she was coming over to yours and hanging out with Casey.
That, yeah.
Awkward.
Steve.
I think obviously, like, I love Case, but he knows that I back myself over him any day of the week.
It was a confidence thing.
I did wonder whether it was a little bit like, yeah, try it, babes. It's not going to happen.
Yeah, maybe there was a little bit of that. But no, like, it was his experience as well. I'd obviously not been in there like, that long. He just walked in. But yeah.
You knew he was going in, didn't you?
Yeah, obviously.
Yeah. Did you bump into each other on the beach or something?
No.
Did you bump into anyone on the beach before?
Because I was. Remember Chugs? I bumped into Chugs.
Chugs?
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
He didn't go on.
No, he was just there on holiday. I remember I was on the beach and this guy comes over and like, oh my gosh, Tom Clare. I'm like, look, I'm like, what the fuck? And then Chugs is there. I was like, how you doing, mate? You're all right. Like,
wait, so he wasn't going in?
No, he was just on holiday. Just bumped into him on the beach.
I saw Lewis in the gym before I went in.
Did you say hi or you're not allowed?
We weren't allowed. We were kind of like rushed apart.
Oh.
Yeah.
They're panicking. Run, run!
We were literally like, get her out the gym now.
The chaperone's got so stressed with stuff like that.
Yeah. He's like, we need to go. Yeah. I was like, okay.
Well, she's probably going to get fired. So yeah. I feel like I understand that. Like, but it is weird because there's no way, I feel like there's no way of like getting away from that kind of thing before you're going in. But did you have an idea? Obviously, you were thinking maybe Callum was going to be in there.
Yeah.
Was there anyone else that you thought might have been in there that didn't go in?
That didn't go in.
Yeah. Or that did. Or that you were right about.
I remember seeing articles about Josh going in.
I had a feeling Sophie and Joanna were going in.
I had no idea.
Just because watching the stories, all those girls are like going gym. And I was like, oh, yeah. See, over Christmas, no one would be doing that.
Casey went for a fucking run on Christmas Day.
I did.
Did you?
Yeah, but I actually did that out of choice. But also, yeah,
because you wanted to get away from the fam. I feel you on that. Give me 10 minutes out. Obviously, going back to Toby and Georgia, they had a journey in there. Mm-hmm. But Chris and Joanna were saying last week they think they're going to get married.
Chris and Joanna,
No.
Toby.
Chris and Joanna think Toby and Georgia are like in it for the long haul.
Oh yeah,
yeah.
They're very similar people.
Are they?
Yeah,
very similar. They were just together all the time.
Really?
Yeah.
All the time.
Yeah.
Well, it is kind of that thing. It's like safety, isn't it, as well? Because they knew each other already, and once they'd solidified that bond, I mean, the drama of Toby. That man pretends to be chill. He's the most dramatic person in there. And I live for it. He was like, do you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to throw a whatever in the pigeons. Cat in the pigeons. He really did throw a cat in the pigeons.
Yeah, we couldn't believe it when
I was
sat there.
Shocked. Your vote. Oh, my.
So when that was going on, when he was doing his speech and Arabella was stood there, I was looking at Arabella going, oh. Like this. I was like, oh, how cute, like this. And then Arabella was like, it's not about me. And I was like, eh? And then he went, Georgia. And I was like, what the? What?
Well, it's like what when he started to make comments like, time waits for no man. The long and the short of it is, I've got to take the risk of a life. And I was like, okay, something weird is going to happen here.
What was it? Fortune
favors, the brave.
Yeah.
Did you know where that came from?
No.
Okay, so here's some tea for you. Joe had a ring that said, fortune favors the brave. He gave that ring to Chris. Chris then wore that ring. He then gave that ring to Toby.
He gave the ring to Toby.
And then Toby gave the ring back. And then Chris gave it to Joanna when he left. Fucking and that's hell. Where fortune favor the brave came from.
Oh, Chris did tell me the story about Joe giving him the ring, but I didn't realise that he passed it on to Toby. He passed it on to Chris and Joe. And
it was some weird communal ring.
Yeah, that's mad. I didn't even know that.
Yeah. So that's why. Georgia, H and Anton. Lovely, sweet, sweet people. Seems like these guys are going from strength to strength on the outside. They're doing a lot of, like, I've seen a lot of stuff on socials.
Yeah.
Like, they're kind of, because the people have said on the show in the past that their conflict is pretty heavy in the villa. Like, they were arguing quite
a lot.
They're
a fiery kind of couple.
I don't think that's a bad thing, though.
It's not bad.
No.
No.
It just means that they're quite, like, emotional.
Passionate.
Yeah, passionate, that's the right word.
If you were arguing, it probably shows that you don't really care.
Yeah.
What I mean, so...
And they both really, like, what I loved is because obviously there was Casey and Georgia were having the chat about her suggesting that his grandpa had psychologically connected with her on a metaphysical level.
Yeah.
And that kind of freaked him out. But I feel like Anton not freaked out.
He embraced
not
it.
At all.
If anything, probably waiting to hear from beyond the grave.
Yeah. waiting for his reading.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I feel like that's one of the cutest things about them is like he really made an effort to be like,
oh no, he did.
Even
he
on
really
the
did.
Was it the Valentine? He set it up.
Yeah.
Else,
yeah, she told us about the Valentine's thing that he did for her. You know, the dates, everyone had their own date.
Yeah.
What was it he was doing? He had her little egg, didn't he?
Yeah. And he went through, and got like Eugene. The spiritual journey. I don't even know.
Spiritual journey, yeah. He did.
Childhood regression, where you go into your brain and pretend you're holding hands with your childhood self.
Sorry?
No, just me. Don't worry about it.
I was like, what?
It's a really cool thing. You should definitely
you
do.
You remind me of Chris so much.
Yeah, you do.
So much.
Stop saying that. Yeah, I just feel like they have that cute... But I really want them to... Because everyone keeps saying, like a lot of people from the show have said that they don't think that they're going to last. What are your guys' thoughts? Because I really... I feel like they're love's young dream.
In the villa, maybe that's why they were so like... having little mini bickers and stuff. Mm. I think on the outside, they might work a lot better.
Mm. Yeah.
Because I think Anton needs a bit of routine, doesn't he?
He's routine.
Yeah. Yeah, apparently he gets up at like 4 a.m. or something.
Yeah. Used to get up with him, didn't
you? Yeah, he used to wake me up to work out in the mornings. I'd do a little...
I would punch him straight in the face if he woke up.
And I'd have a shower and get back in bed and be like, oh, good morning, everyone.
That is...
I know.
I could tell when you've been in the gym because you had so much... You was like, up in the morning.
Yeah.
No, she hasn't been, she'd be like this.
All right.
The energy... Also, then by like 4 p.m., are you like, I'm going to sleep?
No.
They're pretty long days in the villa, no? The
longest... Yeah, but then sometimes you won't wake up till like 1:30, 1 o'clock.
P.m.?
Yeah.
Slay. Yeah. Well, even when you're filming?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So they'd give you
they'd be up all night.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh my God, I could.
It's really weird.
Oh my God, that's so fun. Sleeping in.
Yeah,
not when the
don't
birds
know
are
that.
Tweeting in the morning.
Oh, you don't know what time it is?
No concept of time.
God, that creeps me out, you know? Has it been weird looking at a watch since you've been out?
Like forget about that.
And like your phones, it's weird having your phone in your hand.
Yeah, it's weird having your phone.
How has it been waking up? I know, Tommy, you were just saying it's been weird waking up in your flat.
Yeah, I've been waking up and in the middle of the night, I woke up, I was like, where the fuck am I?
Yeah.
Then it takes me like 2 minutes, I'm like, oh, I'm here, back to bed.
Yeah. I'm here, I can sleep again now. Yeah. No one's coming in
no
and turning the light on.
Oh, that's the worst.
Feel like you should, yeah, that's horrid.
It's so bright.
So bright.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's why, because it took me a few seasons to realise that's why everyone wears sunglasses in the morning.
It hurts your eyes.
Yeah, it's painful.
Yeah.
But that's you've already been up for 5 hours, I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah.
What kind of workouts did you do?
Like, oh, the worst. We ran around the pool. And then I'd do like a little bit of like abs and stuff in the gym bit.
Yeah.
And then just call it a day because there's not really much else you can do. But running around the pool was so boring.
I was going to say that seems boring. To be the definition of insanity, doesn't
it?
Yeah.
How many laps did you do? I'm sure Casey did 100.
Of course he did.
How many did you do? 101?
No, I think I did like 80. But he didn't do 100. No way. He's a little.
He
like,
said he did.
Of course he did.
Yeah. I feel like your friendship's probably made up of a lot of that.
Yeah.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Me and him are like polar opposites, like, but then I'm the chill guy. When we're together, he brings a daft side out of me sometimes.
Yeah.
That's nice, though.
Yeah.
Is he a silly sausage? Apparently on the way, when they were coming back in, you know, when they came back in to do the vote, he was like making everyone like piss their pants.
Really?
He was being really silly. Him and Chris are kind of similar in that sense.
Yeah,
they're kind of just like silly sausages.
Yeah.
And Josh as well, though. They all like each other on, like kids.
Really?
We'd all be sat there, me, Soph, and that. Be sat on the beds just watching them all, like...
Remember that time, Josh?
Like having children, like...
Yeah.
And Josh started dancing on his own. Remember, he was singing.
No.
You remember, he sat next to Soph and they were all asleep and he's, like, going like this.
When?
On the day, he was on the day bed.
What happened?
Where were we?
We was on the sun deck.
We were on the sun deck and we were just watching and everyone was just kind of, like, relaxing. And in the day beds, there was someone sat on one
Sophie
of the beds.
And someone else.
And then it was Sophie and
they
Josh.
They were both sleeping.
Everyone was asleep and Josh was just sat like,
like
we were watching him for ages and he was getting more and more energetic, like dancing.
There's no music.
On his
There's no music playing.
And no one was interacting with him.
No, and me and Tom were just watching him from afar like, what is he doing?
So he, do you know what I love about that? He was really doing that for himself.
Himself? Yeah. No one else.
He was just
vibing
having
on his own.
A whale of a time.
Yeah.
That's the opposite of an attention seeker. It's like, I'm going to do this when no one can see me.
Yeah.
What a sleigh.
I know.
I haven't met him yet, but he seems like a lovely boy.
Yeah, he's so nice.
And I feel like what? How do you feel about Josh and Sophie? Because I feel like they've got legs.
No. Yeah, I love them too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It feels like they really liked each other.
Really smitten.
Yeah, they had some... Because Chris was saying... last week that Josh kind of hides his feelings, but actually he's a real softy teddy bear.
Yeah. When he used to have to do his recoupling speeches and he'd stand there.
Oh, I'd be so nervous, bless him, standing up. Yeah. Some of them recoupling speeches, like, people had to like go like do them so many times because people...
I didn't have to do one.
Yeah.
I know.
No, I can't. I was fuming. Tell me how you feel.
Yeah, you were like, tell me that you love me. That's the thing, though. I did notice that not the girlies didn't do that many recoupling.
God.
Yeah.
Thank
you don't like
God.
It?
No.
Not a public speaker?
At all, no.
No.
Shocking. I shake.
I really like you, Tom. when you're doing it, Tom, how many times was the most times you had to do your recoupling speech again?
I think what they'd say is like, elaborate on stuff to a lot of people.
What was it? That was what Chris was saying, but they would elaborate. Like, you'd be in it and you'd do it and then they'd go,
yeah.
Elaborate.
Yeah, well,
Mitch's speech was the funniest speech I've ever seen.
Have you watched any of it back? Because I don't know what's been...
I haven't.
No, we did see the how bonkers it went, yeah.
When he was like... What was it he said?
He was like something like, time flies in here, but I can't tell the time, or something like that. But when he's like, his liver is there, yeah, and he's like looking there, like into like the abyss. And what else did he say?
Wait, so he wasn't even looking at her when he was doing it?
No, when he was like looking at you, he's like looking in the mirror.
Oh, yeah, and then...
Whilst he's looking at like, a pigeon.
He's not even looking at her, and then he's looking elsewhere.
Josh was saying to him, oh, come on, bro, tell about personality looks. And he goes, shut the fuck up, Josh. Or something like that.
Iconic. Yeah. What is Mitch like? I mean, obviously, we've had him on the show.
Is what you see is what you get.
Yeah.
I love Mitch.
He's very honest, isn't he?
Yeah.
He really caused some drama when he came in and did the... when they were picking which couple was going to leave. I was like, Mitch came with flames.
Yeah, he don't hold back. I didn't think I was going to get on with him at first, but I actually really did.
He seems like a very sweet boy. When he came on the show, he mostly talked about how enraged he was that they wouldn't let him fix the shower.
Oh, really?
Oh, my God, yeah, because we had no hot water for, like, the first 5 days.
He was like, I am a trained professional.
Apparently, is he a plumber?
He's
a gas engineer.
Yeah, gas engineer. Don't know how that helps him make the water go hot, but anyway.
Yeah, is that the same thing?
You're asking the wrong guy.
Yeah, we're asking all the wrong people here. One thing that I've asked all of our guests is, outside of All Stars, it does appear that you all just date each other. You don't even need to be in All Stars.
Oh, no.
Because Love Islanders just date each other. Talk to me about that. What? Because I...
Incestuous.
It feels like... Are you allowed to date outside people who've been in Love Island, or...?
It's a weird one.
Well, I don't know. I think it's because we all go to events and stuff together.
Yeah.
In it.
Yeah.
Drink. Yeah.
What I want to see is some, like, nefarious snogging. Like, does that happen a lot where you'll be in...
No, I don't know.
No, I don't know.
Oh, I think I know.
No, I don't know.
You do know because you were there.
No, I don't know.
Not you weren't there.
No, I know.
He wasn't there.
Yeah. But also, I didn't deliberately say that. And then as soon as I said it, I was like, oh, you did that. Some Islanders have said All Stars was a friendship contest.
Oh,
so as in not in a bad way, but a lot of the votes were skewed towards people's mates.
Okay,
what do you guys feel about that? Obviously, I know Joe was pretty upset when he went out.
I think obviously I've seen the stuff that obviously with Joe and stuff, but in that sense, like we was there for ages, going round and round, and then someone had said something else, and we'd go off that, and we pick a different couple and another couple. So they've only shown the bit that when we said Joe and Joanna, they haven't. Showing the bits that we spoke about everyone. Mm, there was other people that we was close to having to send
home
as well.
Back and forth.
It wasn't just like Joe and Joanna straight away. That wasn't the case at all.
No.
How many hours are you there doing those, like...
Well, we were actually getting told to hurry up, weren't we?
Yeah.
Guys, we elaborate no more. Yeah, we want to go to bed.
Literally.
They were like, we need to hurry up.
Yeah.
Because we were there for that long trying to discuss it.
Because it's kind of like you don't want to be... That's the difference between normal Love Island and All Stars. I think in a big way, because a lot of you do know each other.
Yeah.
They were all lovely. It was a really good group.
It did seem like you had a lot of fun.
Yeah.
And realistically, in the grand scheme of things, the drama was quite minimal, really, because, I mean, there were no licking tits or, you know what I mean? Like, they could have been worse.
The drama was mad.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Good stuff.
Yeah.
I was just trying to help you guys out there, but obviously
it was bad.
It was bad.
Yeah.
Do you think that not having Casa Amor made a difference? Because that's usually so dramatic.
Yeah, but I don't know if there would have been space for Casa Amor with all the drama that was already going on.
Yeah, that was the most intense environment.
Yeah, the movie night thing was pretty...
Yeah, that was a lot.
Yeah, that was quite.
And I feel like, again, it's that thing of in the moment, hot spot, like I'm annoyed, I'm going to say this thing. And then you have to walk off. Because, you know, if you have an argument, you can walk off and leave.
Oh,
you can't leave.
You have to come back.
You have to walk off and then go. You have to walk back in again.
Exactly.
Which is.
I actually did get up and walk off at one point and then got told to sit back down.
Oh, that is annoying.
Yeah.
I know, because we were speaking to Chris and Joanna about when they were getting voted for loads in that challenge, and they were saying what came out on telly, it was actually way worse. It was like 12 rounds of everybody thinking that they were the, you know, least compatible and all that stuff.
Oh, God, yeah.
And Joanna was really upset. And she was like, I don't get emotional, but I did because of the intensity of the moment. I feel like there's more moments than that, like that, sorry.
You only get like a snippet, don't you, really?
Yeah.
If it's into it, it's a lot more intense and longer than it's shown.
People think it's a holiday, but in that place, sometimes it can be a hell of a lot.
Yeah.
It can be a lot.
Yeah. Is there a moment that you can recollect where you felt like, oh my God, I'm not sure if I can do this? About 17 for you, Molly, is it?
There was quite a few. There was one day where I was just like, oh, I've had enough, and I kind of just went inside, removed myself.
Yeah.
So I just kind of kept myself to myself that day. I think everyone went through a bit of a moment. It is very intense in there.
Cool.
So I think, speak to your family, can't
no, you can't speak to anyone. And I don't know. It's just, if you're having arguments and stuff with people and situations and the vibe's a bit off, you don't really want to be around them, but there's nowhere else for you to go, so.
Which is why it's so good. It's testament to a lot of people in there for just squashing beef as soon as possible.
Yeah.
What made you both agree to doing All Stars? It's obviously a big decision going back in the villa.
Yeah, it is. I don't know. I think like you don't really get the opportunity to do it once a lot of the time.
Yeah.
And then when it comes around again, you just kind of have to take it, don't you?
Yeah.
It's All Stars as well, so.
And we're single.
And
no, and I'm assuming neither of you regret it because it's come out.
Oh.
Yeah, smelling of roses.
I know, yeah.
Yeah, and you got 50 grand, so no problem there.
So you can't really regret it, can
No,
you?
I don't regret it.
What was your biggest worry about going back in, though?
Egos.
Interesting. So being around, because the difference, I'm assuming, not to put words in your mouth, but I'm assuming you mean because when the first time you went in, everyone was unknown, quote unquote, whereas you're going back in and everyone's a celeb.
Yeah, I was walking out, I thought, there's going to be people in here that I'm going to clash with, and I remember even telling to Josh, I was like, I thought I might have clashed with Josh, but it was like my brother in there. But you always think like there's going to be big egos and stuff like that, but there was literally none of that.
Oh, that's really interesting. Molly, what was your biggest worry, do you think?
Was it
Callum, realistically?
Probably that, knowing that there's a high potential that he'd come in or already be in there.
Yeah.
I'm probably more just thinking that I might not find someone in there because everyone's already been on it.
Yeah.
So
it is weird as well, because like that thought, I think you did see certain all-stars who went back in and realised, like I think Jake's probably a good example of someone who was like, there is no one in here for me, I'm going to go.
Fair play.
And I feel like that is, fair play if that's how you feel.
You didn't carry on trying to like force it. He just sort of called.
Which I think is quite representative of like, he actually genuinely did go in there. And I think similar with Chris, he was like, as soon as Joanna went, he was like, get me out of here.
Yeah, you could tell.
Bless him.
How was All Stars different from your series? Ego-wise, like energy-wise?
I think it was a better group of people.
Yeah, I'd agree. How was it different?
Intensity, I think.
Emotional.
Yeah.
I feel like it was actually on a higher scale of like
the normal.
A lot more intense. I didn't feel like it was like that first time around.
Yeah.
Everything was just times two.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But in good ways and bad ways.
Yeah.
How did you find being in South Africa? Because you were in South Africa, weren't you? But you were in South Africa as well? I get confused.
Different villa, but you were in the same one as this one.
Oh, it was the weirdest thing ever.
So he was coming back into the same villa.
Yeah.
That's berserk. I didn't realise that.
The weirdest thing ever, walking back in and seeing different people where I'm used to seeing other people sit. It was a lot. And now in my holding villa, I was in the exact same holding villa. Same
No way. Yeah. I didn't know that.
Whoa, that must have felt so weird.
And I actually, so I flew out on the 5th of Jan, and then the year before I flew out on the 5th of Jan. It's like everything was just weird.
Crazy.
Maybe they were trying to like fuck with you a little bit, because that does sound like pretty coincidental.
Was it 18 days you were in holding?
18
for
days
then?
I was in holding.
That's long, isn't it?
I was chilling. I was on the beach, gymming, I was chilling.
I just don't know if I would be able to do it without not being desperate to go on TikTok or something.
Oh, no.
I was just playing.
No, what's going on?
Yeah. Just help someone tell me. Tell me
what's happening.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wait, did you not get to watch it, though?
Yeah.
Oh, you got to watch the show?
Wait, every night?
Yeah.
Ah. Oh.
That's kind of good. So you got to watch telly as normal, but just no phones.
Yeah, like you had like a fire stick. You watch like Netflix and stuff like that.
Sick.
Yeah, chilling.
I watched Saltburn.
Oh,
I haven't seen that yet.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay, which bit did you gag at?
The bath.
Yeah. I did the biggest gag.
Honestly, I gasped. I was like...
I went...
yeah.
Because that viscerally in my brain...
It makes me feel a bit sick.
Wait till you see it.
Yeah, yeah,
a bit unwell.
In my brain, because there were so many things that happened. There were so many things you could have gagged at.
Oh my God, yeah, no, there's another... Yeah, I'm having flashbacks of quite a few moments now.
It's that bit, though.
Yeah.
Salty bathwater.
Stop. Oh my God.
I've heard about it.
Yeah.
No. It's really, really good film.
Hearing
though.
About it, it's not the same as actually seeing it.
I don't
yeah.
want to see it
no,
now.
You will.
I actually saw this TikTok about this dad who was told to watch it by his daughter and he was voice noting her throughout going, what is he fucking doing now? Why is he in the bath with his mouth?
Oh, yeah. Horrible.
Honestly, one of the funniest things I've ever seen. But really good film, though.
Yeah, great.
Really good film.
Yeah.
Anyway, that's not
my mind off yeah. to go in.
Yeah. So how did Molly prep? She watched Saltburn.
Yeah.
Shout out Emerald Fennell for that one. So how's it been coming out? Because obviously it's an intense experience. Tom, you were saying, obviously, you're waking up every day thinking you're still in the villa.
Yeah.
But how well, how has it been? Have you guys been able to hang out much?
No.
We haven't really. Have
no.
We?
But saying that, though, obviously when we came back last week,
yeah,
we were in London for...
Was it two nights?
Yes,
it was two nights.
It was two nights.
And then we came back up. I met your family.
And then, yeah, and then we had the weekend at our homes.
Spent time with family.
Family and friends.
Because you kind of need to go back down to earth a little bit. Yeah.
Yeah. And then Monday we've come back.
Oh, and so what's the plan going forward? Because obviously you live in different places right now, but Tom, you were saying you're moving up north anyway to play football. Is that right?
Yeah, so my plan even before the show, football's my passion. It's what I've always done. My team, Macclesfield, hopefully have me back. And obviously I wanted to move back up to Manchester, close to my family and stuff like that. So yeah, that's my plan.
How many keepy uppies can you do?
Yeah, good question. I've never asked that.
Thank you.
Just give me a ball. You got a ball?
No, Tom. I haven't brought a ball with me
have
to the
shoot.
Have
you never tried it?
What?
Surely you've tried it.
Me and you, we'll have a little competition.
No, but right, I want to give me a ballpark of how many balls you can
rough
pop.
Estimate.
What? Just till I get bored.
No, oh, so what do you mean? You can do more than five?
Guinness World Book of Records. Is that what it is? No.
No, I'm not saying that, but I mean...
Give me a number.
Like, I don't know, like 500 something.
No, you can't.
No, you
that
can't.
That is utter bullshit.
Your foot would fall off.
Ask any footballer. I bet they could do it. It's just
okay, boredom. David Schmeichel.
David Schmeichel, that well-known player, David Schmeichel.
Is that not a player?
No, that's his name, yeah.
What is his name?
David Schmeichel.
Yeah, I see.
Yeah.
Who's the guy I used to fancy, the goalie, from when we won the World Cup? Alan Shearer. No. David Seaman.
Oh,
David
yeah.
Seaman.
I'm a lesbian, babe. Nothing makes any sense. Like, anyone that I say I fancy, I wouldn't trust it for the barge pole. Lots of people are saying you're the new Molly and Tommy because
what?
Molly and Tom, but it's giving that energy.
Oh, I just got it right.
Molly May and Tommy.
No.
Everyone's kind of giving that vibe, but I just wondered if you were going to be the new Molly and Tommy, which of you would be the boxer? Who's got box? Yeah, I knew it'd be you, Molly. I knew it'd
Thank
be you.
You. Thank you very much. I used to do a little bit.
Did you?
No, I'm lying. I actually did it sometimes, like as a workout.
Yeah.
I actually went on a fitness retreat and me and my friend did it. We actually are really good
Show
at it.
Show me how you box. No, like throw a punch.
I was doing it with Chris in the villa. What? Did he not back me?
No, I didn't ask him.
Oh.
I didn't ask him, but I'm sure he would have.
He said I've got a really good punch on me.
Did he?
Yeah.
Go on, give him a jab.
I'm feeling a bit...
Go on, give him a jab.
I can't.
You can.
Give him a little one. Give him a little one.
You can.
No, I feel like we're in a bit of a close proximity.
Yeah, that's okay.
I feel like I need to be...
Just don't get his face.
Well.
Go on then.
I'm scared.
Do it.
I've got rings on.
Just do it. Give me a whack. Oof.
Oh! Sorry, but she was doing that at a disadvantage being sat in a position like
thank
this.
You.
I know, she's got full swing on that.
And you look quite strong,
Tom. Heads are getting taken off.
That was a full... Hey.
My girl.
I look forward to the swapping energy of the new Molly and Tom, one of which the Molly's the boxer this time.
Yeah, watch me go.
This is the part of the show called Pillow Talk, where we ask the guests the important questions in life, and we can't talk about important things in the Love Island villa without putting on a pair of sunglasses.
Absolutely.
Because you know you have those morning chats and no one can do that without... And literally, we all seem to watch you go like this. right, now ready. Let's talk about who you snogged last night.
Oh, if the glasses aren't on, you can't talk.
Yeah, no, exactly. Yeah. And it's like, take it off, put it back on.
Yeah.
So, these are our big questions. Are you ready?
I'm ready. Let me look at Hang on. Do I look okay?
Oh, you look really nice. Oh, you look really a vibe. Nice.
Yeah.
You look cool.
Yeah, you do.
Yeah, cheers.
Okay, don't worry about me then.
More often. You look amazing as well.
Thank you.
I
so
like
much.
The glasses and the sunglasses.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I appreciate that,
You're
Molly.
Welcome.
Tom, got anything to say about me?
Beautiful.
Thank you. Can you ever really be friends with your ex?
Well, yeah, I think we've proved that.
Pillow talk. We're saying yes. I agree. One of my exes is my best friend.
Oh, wow. Are we just giving a one-word answer?
No, absolutely not. We're discussing
deep,
it, babe.
Forehead.
Oh, sorry. I thought,
no, go deep. Throw
your opinion in.
Oh. So what do you think? Obviously, you have had to put that to the test. So, Molly, you're saying, yes, you do.
Yeah.
Your snort is so sweet. No, it's so
not.
Sweet.
I think it is when you've been around me about 5 minutes.
Oh, right.
Give it a few months and it'll be like, yeah.
It's grating.
Your brother was like, the first time it was said it was cute, and then your brother was like, last night, no, it annoys him, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Tom, how are you feeling about the snort?
I like it, yeah.
It's not been long enough. It's not been long enough.
It's not been long enough, yeah. Give me a few months.
Tom, what do you think? Can you be friends with your ex?
Yeah, I think obviously Molly and Callum have proved that, yeah.
Are you friends with any of your exes?
No.
No, but you know what? Boundaries, hun. Boundaries.
Yeah,
put those boundaries in.
Certain circumstances.
For sure.
Yeah, 100%.
It depends on the situation. If you broke up and it was really bad, break up. No, I'm not friends with any of my other exes.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. I'm friends with one ex and we're literally best friends. I'm not friends with any of the others.
Exactly.
So it's one rule for you and one rule for everyone else.
There we
but
go.
That's, you got to have your boundaries in.
Yeah.
Yep.
Can you be friends with your partner's ex?
Well, yeah, me and Carl. I think, like I said, on the outside world, it would not be a thing.
Yeah.
I think because we've been chucked into this environment, I probably wouldn't have even spoke to Carl really on the outside.
No.
If that was the case, but we've been put in the environment and we've got on, so yeah.
Molly?
Well, I don't know any of your... Oh, yeah, like, well, you wouldn't say G's your ex, would you?
No.
But you're friends with the sort of person that he once dated.
Yeah.
So you've tested it out a little bit.
Yeah.
And it worked.
Yeah, so I'd say... Yeah.
Yeah.
I think
maybe
so.
Maybe not best friends.
No.
Yeah.
That would be slightly bizarre.
Not when you're comparing starting the chat. What?
Why did you spin your head back?
For effect.
Yeah, it's dramatic. Yeah. It's dramatic.
Stop doing that. It freaks me out.
I also think... No, sorry. I don't
this
think I'm
really
ever not going to find
I don't
it
like
cute
it.
With a snore.
Do you not like it?
It's just weird when you flick your head like that.
I do it on purpose.
She's just trying to engage with you, Tom.
Yeah.
We haven't seen each other in a couple of days.
Wow.
I think in terms of being friends with your exes, as I was mentioning earlier, all people in Love Island seem to only date each other. So surely... It's a constant sensation of walking into an event and seeing exes, partners of exes, new ones, old ones. Like, surely this is just a consistent thing with people who've been in Love Island.
Yeah, fair point, actually.
Yeah.
It feels like every event you go to, there's at least one person you've snogged. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Not you personally, but in general world, like somebody is going to know someone who snogged someone in that room, without a doubt.
Yeah.
And by the way, before we go, just on that note, everyone who's come out the villa has said that... like when you snog in the villa outside of the person you really like, that it is just like a job. It's like so unemotional.
Like in the games and stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah, 100%.
Yeah.
Is that...
Do you agree?
Yeah, it's just like, it's a bit of a weird scenario.
Yeah.
I think if you're in a couple as well, it's a bit awkward. Like, kind of after...
And you're like this.
Yeah.
And then
there's that one person that goes, ooh.
Yeah.
And it's Mitch.
How do you feel about that?
And it's Mitch.
Yeah. It would be.
That was a passionate kiss.
Yeah, I was just about to say, that looked really good, that kiss. Yeah. How do you feel about
there's
that?
There's always one person that says
And you have
it.
To sit there and be like, yeah, fine.
I just really keep thinking about your tongue's been in their mouth, now it's in my mouth. I don't know how.
That's the whole point of these sort of games. You all just end up kissing each other. Who was it who kissed every girl?
Toby.
Yeah, that's what they were saying last week.
I think he came up with that himself.
Did he?
Yeah, sure Chris and Toby were like in competition to see who could kiss every girl in the villa,
I think. I'm sure he was like, I'll kiss every girl.
Yeah.
He just went for it.
I mean, slay for him, but not for me. I mean, I love to snog, but it feels like a too much. Too much.
Anton had a little mouth spray as well, so sometimes we just pass that around a little bit.
Do we think he's going to get a deal with Colgate? Because he really shouldn't he?
Should.
He was literally like every 5 seconds.
Yeah.
I also don't think I've seen someone use mouth spray since 1942. So
yeah, he's bringing it back.
He
but
really
even, like,
is.
At dinner and that, like obviously when there's no cameras, he's like this. Yeah. Like, all the time.
Loved it.
Yeah.
He really loves the taste of mint in his mouth.
Yeah.
Good for you, girl. Good for you. And also, just because I've just suddenly thought of this before we go, the dance, because on the note of the snogging,
oh, no,
the sexy
please.
Dance challenge.
Let's not talk about that.
Why?
Oh, that was tragic.
You were great.
No, never, ever.
It.
No.
You smashed
no.
it. You smashed
no.
it. But how on earth? It gives me the absolute fear.
I didn't want to do it.
Yeah.
I said, can I present it? And they was like, well,
what do you mean present it?
Exactly. That's what they said to me. I was like, I can present it. I could introduce the girls and cheer them
oh
on.
Oh my God, I love that. You wanted to be the like...
The one that didn't have
the
to
madame of the situation. Like, yeah. Ladies and gentlemen.
Oh my God, yeah.
There is... Welcome to the Moulin Rouge.
There you go. So wow, I could have presented it.
Yeah.
I didn't even think of that. Yeah.
Sorry, I should have given you that idea before you went in.
Well, they wouldn't give us much drink before.
How many did you have? Two or one?
I had one.
I think we had one.
Have to neck it. I'd have to literally be like, go.
And then you stand there behind the door, your music starts, and then...
So they have got music?
Yeah, the music's loud on that.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, really loud.
Yeah.
And then Vogue comes on and she's like, right, you ready? 3, 2, 1.
Go.
And you just think, I'm going to be sick.
I would have just roly-polied in there and sat on someone's lap, honestly, and just been like, do you want to chat for two? Do you want to chat for two?
Can I pull you for a chat?
Yeah, can I pull you for a chat? Because honestly, this is hell.
Yeah, it was. It was tragic. And that walk
all
the way down the steps.
It's about 10 minutes.
And then you can walk all the way back as well. Nothing worse. Honestly, worst moment ever.
And on that note, guys, it's been a pleasure.
Thank you.
Huge congratulations on winning Love Island All-Stars. You are both lovely and very sweet together. And I look forward to seeing your boxing career take off.
Me too.
And Tom, as her manager. Yeah, as her manager, you will, I'm sure, be brilliant. Thank you so much for joining us on the Under the Duvet podcast. We have loved having you here. It has been a pleasure. Make sure you go back and watch all the episodes over and over and over again and give us those views. And guys, thank you so much.
Thank you.
This
has been Under the Duvet with Molly and Tom.